Everybody's falling in love and I'm falling behind.
Did you know Pearl from Finding Nemo is a flapjack octopus, which is a super cute deep sea octopus? In fact, this cephalopod is so cute that scientists have thought about giving it the scientific name Adorabilis. There are around 24 flapjack octopus species out there, and they can come in red, pink, orange, and other flavors. Their body kind of looks like a pancake when it is resting on the seafloor, hence the name flapjack octopus. They have small filaments called cirri that line their arms, and they will use them to find food in the sediment. They eat small worms and crustaceans on the seafloor, and it is not a very good swimmer, so sometimes this octopus will spread its arms out and take on an umbrella shape to float gently to the seafloor. Unlike other cephalopods, these animals don't have access to camouflage abilities, so they hide in plain sight many times, and with some of them being red in coloration, many deep sea predators cannot see them because red wavelengths do not reach the deep sea. They can reach about a foot in length, and they kind of look similar to the Dumbo octopus many of you may have already heard of. Comment down below what you want to see next.
A quiet down, if it's what you want. I understand I'm not the only one for you.
Melanie looks a lot like Stephanie. She looks a lot like Jane. Who looks a lot like Amy?
Yes. crack a rib. When I get home, I'm gonna bury you.
Meet one of the cutest animals that you didn't know existed, the sea sheep. They are also called leaf sheep or leaf slugs. This sea slug uses photosynthesis and is one of few animals that actually does so. These little guys only reach a maximum size of 1 centimeter, and it has these two little black eyes and two rhinophores, which look like antennae or, to some, sheep's ears. These rhinophores help them navigate and find food in the water, and the sea sheep gets its green color from a rarely observed process known as kleptoplasty, where the animal can keep chloroplasts from the algae that it eats. In doing this, the animal can gain energy from photosynthesis as well, and these chloroplasts are found on the cirrhata found on the animal's back. This solar-powered sea slug was only discovered around 3 decades ago, but it appears to be doing just fine population-wise, and it is thought that there's not that many threats to this animal. It is able to blend in quite well to its environment, which it typically spends a lot of its time on green algae that it consumes, and this helps the animal stay away from predators.
Seen a feather star? If not, get ready to be amazed. These fascinating creatures are some of the most beautiful and unique animals in the ocean. Feather stars, also known as crinoids, are marine animals related to starfish, sea urchins, and sea cucumbers. And unlike their relatives, they can move around freely, using their feathery arms to swim through the water and even crawl on the ocean floor. These fascinating creatures come in a variety of colors, including red, orange, yellow, green, and blue. Some even have patterns or spots. These arms are covered in tiny, sticky hairs called cilia, which help them catch plankton and other small organisms to eat. And another unique feature is their ability to regenerate. If one of its arms is damaged or lost, it can grow back.